So let's say that I'm a business. I'm willing to sell. I'm approved on Amazon, all that stuff. Explain to me Roman's Tide, the inspiration kind of behind that, and the elevator pitch, if you will.
Yeah. So Roman's Tide is a brand management company for brands looking to expand their online presence, whether it's on Amazon, a Shopify store, or like the Walmart marketplace or whatever else pops up. And it's just a better way to, it's just another way to build your presence, get more brand awareness, get more revenue through your business, reach more customers. And I think it's just a great vehicle to really get your brand known and make some good money in the process.
Why do you think some companies are doing well in business online and some are not? Amazon or not?
Yeah, you know, unfortunately, this is one thing we really try to tackle at Roman's Tide is educating our clients on some of the kind of dirty tactics that go on behind the scenes, because you can do a lot of the right things and you can know marketing and you can know advertising and still fail on Amazon because maybe you're in a really competitive niche and, you know, there might be some guy with an office in China with hundreds of people in there, like just writing fake reviews or something. Like, you know, this stuff is actually happening and going down. And if you kind of just choose to ignore it and not take action in some way, you're not going to get the results that you want to get on Amazon.
Are there police from the review settings of that? Because I mean, I feel like you can go on Amazon and when you're reading some of the stuff, you just look and you're like, people like complaining about like, oh, the box came dented. It's like, well, what's in the box? And they give it a one star review. I'm like, so like, is there any kind of policing on Amazon for stuff like that?
There is. And, you know, I think they're just a little too big to handle it properly yet at this moment. But they do certainly throw a lot of, you know, terms of service stuff at us when it comes to asking for reviews. Like you can't even really put an insert in your packaging, but you kind of can if your language is written a certain way. And then they're always changing what that situation looks like. But like I mentioned earlier, there's some businesses that devote a substantial amount of time and resources into figuring out how to get around these things. And what we found at Roman's Tide is if you don't want to play dirty, you know, that's cool. And we don't necessarily support that or tell people they need to do that. But what we do say is you need to be focused on building a brand and an audience that's loyal to your brand. Because if you have loyal people going to Amazon and shopping for your products and writing reviews, then that's how you can combat against these companies who are just trying to make a dollar on Amazon through gaming the system.
One of the biggest challenges, so I have a book, Anomaly, How to Finally Stand Out from the Crowd. That was the worst pitch ever for a book. You can find it on Amazon. Just type my name, Zach Miller. No, I'm just, so one thing that I can't stand is that I don't know who's bought my book. So allegedly, my dad bought 6 books for his clients and gave them out. Maybe you've bought it before. I have no idea. Tim, the only reason I know Tim has one is because I hand delivered it and I see it behind him, right? So, but I can't stand that I don't know who's bought a book. I know that someone has bought a book because I can see that, you know, the thing is up on my account, but I don't know who, I don't know where, and stuff like that. Is there any way around that? Is that just a book thing? Does that change when people are selling products? Because I know for me, like if I was a retail shop and I couldn't contain that stuff, that would, or in general, like I just can't stand the fact that I can't just thank someone for buying a book. I feel bad, you know? And so is there any way around that? Have you seen anything around that?
Yeah, it, you know, it's Amazon doesn't consider, if you have a store and you put yourself up on Amazon and an Amazon customer buys a product, Amazon considers it their customer, not yours. So like if you do FBA, Fulfillment by Amazon, where you send products into their warehouse, all you're going to see is like the name on the order. And I think you see the address like temporarily. They encrypt the phone numbers now, so you're not even going to see their phone number. If you're doing FBM, Fulfilled by Merchant, and you're sending out those orders yourself, then you're going to see the address. They're still encrypting the phone number. And then if you have like a sales tax software, you can see that information there as well. So you can see who purchased your book there. And then I think after like 30 days, that information disappears. But yeah, Amazon doesn't really like us to have that information, and we're not supposed to do anything with it, but there's plenty of people that are.
The best part about Amazon, you can't get.
Yeah.